knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave Explains.
As we begin our tour of the human material record, our first stop actually takes place before the evolution of Homo sapiens. Paleoarcheology is the study of the material remains of hominins other than Homo sapiens. This is primarily studying lithic material, as nearly every other artifact type doesn't survive the millions of years human evolution takes place within. For a long time, one of the defining traits of the genus Homo was seen as tool use. In fact, one of the reasons Homo habilis was chosen to be grouped with Homo rather than Australopithecus was lithics in nearby context to its remains. However, due to the work of primatologists like Jane Goodall, we realized that other great apes utilized tools. The idea was then that it was lithic tool use that was unique to the genus Homo. Yet again, it was later found that Australopithecines utilized lithic tools, and maybe even hominins like Paranthropus, which are not on the Homo lineage. We know the use of tools was critical to the development of the Homo lineage, and the genus Homo seems to be a lineage that evolved with a reliance on tools, rather than tools being a byproduct of the genus Homo. The first widely accepted lithic artifacts that appear in the archaeological record are Lomequian lithics. These come from a site with the same name, Lomequi III, in northern Kenya, which we discussed earlier in the series. Described in 2015, they represent a lithic assemblage dating to around 3.3 million years ago. It includes several flakes and a core, and one of the primary flakes even fits nicely back onto the core, indicating the site was a lithic production area. At 3.3 million years ago, we are well before the evolution of Homo. Australopithecus is the commonly attributed maker of these lithics, specifically Australopithecus africanus or afarensis. However, this might be our bias again, as Kenyanthropus also lived at this time and was nearby. We currently don't know exactly which hominin made them, since no hominin remains were found in situ with the tools. As expected, the craftsmanship is very limited. It seems like creating sharp edges for cutting and blunt edges for crushing were the two main focuses of the tools. This means only a few flakes were broken off a core and not worked further. The next major group of lithics to appear in the archaeological record are Oldowan tools. This assemblage of lithic tools is much better understood, as it was first described in the 1930s and is known from several sites around eastern and southern Africa. With many sites, we know Oldowan tools were made over a span from 2.9 to 1.7 million years ago. Oldowan tools are more complex than Lomequian, with many different types of tools, such as choppers, scrapers, and hammerstones. Again, we still don't have a very clear idea of the exact hominins that made these tools. The popular idea is that they were made by early Homo species, such as Homo habilis, but it's clear that some of the late surviving Australopithecines had the ability to make and use tools. And once again, there is some evidence that Paranthropus could use tools as well. It's possible that all three genera utilized Oldowan tools. Knowing the relationship these hominins had with each other is very difficult, but it can be interesting to speculate. Oldowan tools show more working and detail than Lomequians, but with the next stone tool type, hominins really began mastering the art of toolmaking. Acheulean lithics are the first tools for which we have a good understanding of who used them. Dating from 2 million years ago to 150,000 BP, these tools were mainly used by Homo erectus. As we discussed, erectus was the first hominin to venture out of Africa. Unsurprisingly, we found Acheulean lithics all over Africa into Europe and across Asia into the Indonesian islands. While Acheulean lithics comprise a variety of tool types, by far the most common and well-known are the Acheulean hand axes. These hand axes show a high degree of skill, hinting at the coordination their growing brains lent them. Hand axes have a rounded end that fits into the palm, coming to a sharp point. They were bifaces, or points that were worked on both sides. They had a variety of uses, likely used in butchering, cutting textiles, and carving wood. Some Acheulean hand axes that have been found are so big they would have been unwieldy to use. This has led to speculation that hand axes may have been used in sexual selection or some early form of ritual activity beyond physical use. Since we're still focusing on understanding how we get to archaeological conclusions, let's look at a study by Dr. Margherita Mussi et al. In it, the archaeologists examine a site in Ethiopia where a Homo erectus jawbone was found at a site containing several lithics. Looking at the stratigraphy, level Garba 4E, highlighted near the bottom, contained the Homo erectus remains as well as Oldowan lithics. Only a little higher, level D contained several Acheulean lithics. Both these levels were dated to between 2.116 and 1.925 million years ago, as seen on the right. These dates were found using magnetostratigraphy. This absolute dating method uses the reversal of the magnetic poles in ferrous rocks to date levels. We discussed this at length in the geology series. This site exemplifies the transition from Oldowan to Acheulean lithics, showing that Homo erectus was likely the hominin to make the transition. It also highly supports the idea that it was known hominins making these tools, in case there was any doubt. After Homo erectus spread through Africa, Europe, and Asia, populations began evolving into many separate species. So too did lithic types, and by 300,000 years ago, dozens existed across these regions. One such example are Mousterian lithics, primarily used by Neanderthals. These new stone tools grew more complex as the brain size of hominins increased. As this complexity increased, stone tools became refined enough to hunt larger and larger game. One species in particular that had been evolving in Africa were creating specialized lithics for hunting large game, Homo sapiens. Let's move forward and see what happened next.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.